Hi guys, I'm Dr. Tara Tobias. I want to welcome you all back to this channel. In today's home exercise tutorial, we're going to go over a topic that's come up a couple of times in the comments. It doesn't affect a lot of you that are part of this community, but the main problem that comes up a few times in the comments is ataxia. So I really want to create a video for those of you that have left that comment wanting more videos on this topic, but ataxia can also be grouped into a bigger category of just balance problems, and I'm going to get into that in a little more detail when we talk about what ataxia is. But the reason I mention that is I am going to be giving some exercises that are good for anyone that has problems with their balance. So whether or not you've had a doctor or a physical therapist use the word ataxia as the cause of your problem, I still think you'll get some value out of this video. But before we dive into that, if you're new to this channel and you haven't yet subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, turn on that notification bell so that you'll be notified every time I upload new videos. Now let's go ahead and dive in. So, ataxia is a movement disorder that is caused by damage to the cerebellum, which is a part of the brain. And the cerebellum is responsible for coordinated voluntary movements. It is also part of the balance system that I talk about a lot, fine motor control, and posture. So as you can see, it plays a huge part in our ability to perform normal everyday movements. So I believe some of you that have asked for more videos on ataxia most likely have had a stroke that has affected your cerebellum, but there are other things that can cause ataxia besides just a stroke or damage to the cerebellum due to a stroke, such as alcohol misuse or abuse. Certain medications, if they're used over a long period of time, can cause ataxia. A tumor in the cerebellum, cerebral palsy, which is brain damage that occurs at birth. Multiple sclerosis can cause ataxia if you have lesions in that part of your brain, and also a traumatic brain injury can cause ataxia. There are also a number of hereditary conditions that can cause ataxia, and the one that I'm the most familiar with is Friedreich's ataxia. So that is just a short list of the medical problems that can cause ataxia, which in most cases is just a term that represents a group of symptoms that are caused by some other medical condition. So some other symptoms, if you have damage to this area of your brain or you've been diagnosed with ataxia or someone is diagnosed with ataxia, are poor coordination, an unsteady walking pattern, and a tendency to stumble, difficulty with fine motor tasks such as eating, writing, or buttoning a shirt, change in speech, involuntary back and forth eye movement, which we call nystagmus, and difficulty swallowing. So of course, if you think you have any of these symptoms, you definitely want to seek medical attention and have a medical team on board to help you figure out what's causing your ataxia to come up with the best treatment plan. So the treatment from a physical therapy standpoint focuses on neuromotor exercises or retraining the brain, which we talk a lot about in several of my videos, focusing on coordination and balance. In addition, physical therapists just have a way of challenging you in the specific areas where you seem to have the most severe symptoms associated with your ataxia. So for instance, just putting you in situations, whether that's standing with your feet close together or standing on one leg, or when you're presented with obstacles, whatever those scenarios are that are causing your ataxia to be the most severe or hinder your movement the most, physical therapists are just skilled in getting you into those situations, providing the right cues to get your body to respond appropriately, with the end goal that over time, the brain can learn how to adjust or accommodate for those situations to prevent you from falling. So the reason I brought up the fact that this would be good for anyone with balance issues is because it's pretty similar to the strategy that we use if you have any breakdown in your balance system, since the cerebellum is a huge part of the balance system that prevents you from falling. So we're gonna go over some exercises today that will hopefully help you if you're someone that's experiencing ataxia, but also help you if you're someone that just has balance problems. So how do we approach this in a way that makes you feel safe to do some of these exercises at home. And it really is by going through a progression that I use with a lot of other movement problems. But really, you want to get your body comfortable with exercises laying down, sitting, and then standing. And this is really important, especially when it comes to ataxia, because if you can control the trunk a little bit or stabilize the trunk a little bit, which is basically your center of mass, your body, and just practice on the coordination of the extremities or the legs in this case, it's much easier to carry that over into sitting where the trunk is less stable and then into standing where there's even more challenges placed on the trunk or the center of mass to be able to maintain an upright position. So in laying down, I really like these heel to shin exercises. This is the most basic exercise for ataxia. You're laying down, your trunk is supported, and you're basically just relearning how to get your legs to move in a smooth, coordinated fashion towards a target. So this would carry over into walking to make sure that you're placing your foot accordingly. And if you have ataxia, I would spend a lot of time on this exercise, especially because your trunk is nice and supported. So you really just have to focus on quality, smooth leg movement. And then, as I just mentioned, that first exercise, your trunk is really supported, but also in this laying down position, we want to try and start working the muscles that stabilize the trunk. So bridging is another exercise that I absolutely think is critical as part of the mat exercises for ataxia. You're starting to demand a little bit more of the trunk in this position and require it to engage a little bit more to stabilize you, with the end goal of being able to carry this over into sitting and then eventually to standing. And then I'm also including in this mat progression tall kneeling. So now we're really demanding a lot more of the trunk. However, you're a little bit lower to the ground, so it's easier to stabilize the trunk. Just think of a really tall tree versus a shorter tree. When the wind blows, the taller tree is going to sway a lot more. The shorter tree isn't going to sway as much. So when you're lower to the ground, your center of gravity is lower to the ground, it's easier to keep that center of mass upright. So that's why I love tall kneeling. Then we're also going to go into some quadruped activities, which is when you're on all fours, on your hands and knees. Again, we're really trying to build that stable core. Now, if you have hemiplegia and your stroke has affected your arm and your leg, you might not be able to do these quadruped activities, but the tall kneeling activity is a really great exercise. So you could just skip over these exercises where you're on all fours. But again, now we're just gonna start doing some leg movement. So we call these donkey kicks, where you just kick your leg backwards. You can do some bird dog exercises, which is when you lift in your opposite arm and leg. Again, that's really challenging that core. Again, with the end goal that we're gonna carry all of this over into standing and walking, so really developing that stable core. If ataxia is your main problem, this is probably a series of exercises that I would do every day. These mat exercises, you cannot do them too much. And then now in standing, the best activity that you can start with if you have ataxia in standing is learning how to stand with your feet touching. This is an exercise that is really scary for a lot of people with ataxia, because you learn really quick to just keep your feet really wide. And by the time you usually get to me or to physical therapy, you've been doing that for a while. So usually people have a really hard time doing this, and it's very, very scary. So my suggestion is you just stand in a corner with your feet touching. What the corner does is it just provides a little bit of a safety net behind you. You can put a walker in front of you just in case, so that you can grab onto it. But again, I would just stand with your feet together. And that is where I'm going to stop for this video. That is a lot of exercises, and I really want anyone who's having really severe balance problems or is struggling with ataxia to really get this foundation. before moving on to the higher, what I call higher level standing and balance activities. So that's why we're gonna stop here, focus on these exercises in preparation for the next video where I'm going to show how you progress from here. So how you progress your base of support, how you start incorporating more trunk rotation and more trunk stabilization in standing. But again, you cannot stand too long with your feet touching like this. You should be able to stand without feeling like you're swaying at all. The nice thing about the corner is if you sway at all, you'll feel it because you'll hit the walls. So again, you could do this exercise for days. The key is you want to be able to stand with your feet touching without any sway. And then in the next video, we're gonna start adding some of the challenges that I mentioned earlier, as well as adding head movement and eye movement, which if you are someone that struggles with ataxia, you know that that can become a challenge when you're walking if you start moving your head or the environment or people start moving around you. So we're gonna address that in next week's video, but I hope you found this video helpful. If so, give it a thumbs up. If you have ataxia, just put hashtag ataxia in the comments. That'll just help me to know if there's more than a couple of you, because right now there's only a couple of you that are commenting that you have been diagnosed with ataxia. So if there's more of you out there, I would just like to know about it. So just drop a hashtag ataxia in the comments below. If you haven't yet subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, turn on that notification bell so that you'll be notified every time I upload new videos. I enjoyed spending time with you all today, and I will see you all in the next video.